I'd been seeing this guy for a couple of weeks and his behaviour became really strange and quite aggressive. And he was pursuing me relentlessly and I sort of felt a bit uncomfortable about the way it had happened. At the same time, I got quite sick. I had cold sores for the first time in my life and I just had an inkling that something wasn't quite right. And I did actually approach him and say, look, is there anything I should be worried about? He got frustrated with that. And eventually I got a message from him saying, well, at least you'll remember me forever. So at that point, I thought maybe the reason I'd been sick was a bit more sinister. So I went back to my GP and said, look, I think you need to test me for HIV. Her response to that was, Abby, you're a young female heterosexual woman in Australia. The chances are just so slim. But I insisted on getting that test. And sure enough, a week and a half later, I got a call back to come in and see the doctor. And that was what it was. They said, you're HIV positive. Receiving that diagnosis, I think the first thing I thought was, I'm a 24-year-old woman. I don't want to live with this. It just felt like the most horrible thing that I could have heard come out of my doctor's mouth. And I think it was so terrifying because I only had the most basic understanding of the disease. I had those images burnt into my mind that I saw as a kid, you know. So it was just, it felt too horrible to be true. My family were very supportive. I know there was a lot of difficult emotions that my parents and family had to deal with, you know, growing up through the scare campaign of the 80s. But I think once I learnt more about it and they learnt with me more about the virus, they've just become the most invaluable source of support for me. Before HIV, I was living in Melbourne independently, studying full-time, and had a great group of friends, much like I still do. Life now, after being diagnosed with HIV, it's a bit different to what I'd pictured. You know, I made some fairly drastic changes in my life as a result of getting that diagnosis, but you know, 18 months down the track, I feel like my life is going exactly where I would want and hope. It is different, but I feel like my life may even be more enriched as a result of this. HIV just carries this stigma, and whether it's because of what people remember from the 80s or whether it's considered a gay disease, I'm not 100% sure, but I know that's the fear. That's the fear that goes with it. When I was diagnosed, people weren't concerned about my health. They were concerned about the social side of me as a 24-year-old woman having to disclose that I'm HIV positive. I was lucky enough to discover the Bobby Goldsmith Foundation through a couple of friends that I'd met at other positive get-togethers. And they had told me about this PozQuest for Life program that was being run. So I was lucky enough to get the opportunity to go on that and just had enormous benefit out of having that weekend away with other positive women, and it was just a beautifully healing experience, which was all provided for us by BGF. I would say that HIV is a virus that affects your health for some people immeasurably. But the reality of this virus, which is different to any other illness, is that the stigma might even be more damaging. And people who need the help most are often not in a position to come forward and ask for that help, and BGF provides those people with that support. So I would say you're doing a fantastic thing if you were supporting an organisation like BGF. The support that BGF provides is just invaluable in helping those that are the most vulnerable.